Back to the Road Show this morning in the buzz. Snobbery may be in the eye of the beholder, but in a recent survey of America's favorite places, travel and leisure found Providence to be in the top 10 for snobby cities. Who knew? The article reminds readers that Providence ranked number one for top cities overall and suggested the snobby factor came into play due to the Capitals' Ivy League affiliation with Brown and the tech savvy in
avant-garde
vibes of locals. Providence has always ranked high, very high, in the list for gourmet food shops. So we wanted to know, what do you think about this ranking and what makes people snobby? Do you think Providence is snobby?
I think you're going to find snobby people anywhere.
Yeah,
you go.
I do too.
And then you won't in some places too. I think characteristics of someone who is a snob, if you will. I feel like they're not open to many things.
Right.
Maybe they're not open to change or to trying something new.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they're always, you know, just someone who just has judgment everywhere.
Sure.
They're just judging. They're going to shut you off for no apparent reason. They're going to be rude for absolutely no reason.
Mm-hmm.
I just think, to me, that's a snob, and someone who's going to put their nose up in the air and say, ugh, I'm above that.
I mean, I do get it when they say because of the affiliations with the schools.
Right.
All right. That I get. Because, you know, that can happen.
Right.
I also think that maybe it's not so much snobby, but it is Rhode Island. And look, I'm not saying anything anybody doesn't know. But here in Rhode Island, everybody thinks they're either someone or they're related to someone. Or
mm-hmm.
don't you know who I am kind of thing.
Right.
And maybe that comes across as a snobby thing. Maybe that's what it is. But, I mean, you know, it's Rhode Island. Everybody's either related to someone
mm-hmm.
or it's the, hey, don't you know who I am kind of thing.
Right. Well, they're trying to
impress you.
Or just, like, uphold this personality that they may or may not really have. But they always may seem like they're on.
Right. But
so
I don't think we're snobby. I don't really know if we're the snobbiest. I think a lot of places are much more snobby than us. I know Boston made the list.
Yep.
But that's also a place that has, you know, the schools themselves.
And I get it because you think, you know, you've got, like, the Harvard and Brown and you think, oh,
but
well.
It's not all of Boston.
But no, and you can't blame a good education.
Right. On being snobby?
Yeah, I mean, I guess that correlation is there.
Sure.
But to me, if you're one of those students who goes to those schools and you automatically get the reputation of, oh, you must be a snob if you go to Harvard or Yale.
It's kind of unfair.
Or whatever it is. It is unfair.
It's unfair to them. Because there's not every place in Providence is snobby. I mean, I'm sure if you're near certain schools, maybe. But, you know, we've done things with, you know, kids around the area in the schools, and they're fine,
mm-hmm.
you know? But I think it's more of the, hey, don't you know who I am, or don't you know who I'm related to thing that may come across as snobby.
And we've also said Rhode Islanders, they hate their change.
They do
they
hate change.
Change.
Rhode Islanders
so
do not like change at all.
Maybe that's part of it as well. Once you start giving some tension towards something, you think, oh,
that could be what it is.
Be a snob. Brendan?
You're not snobby.
Has anyone seen my ascot? I misplaced it somewhere around the set.
Well, near your pipe and your robe. Yeah,
and my monocle, of course. Most importantly, here's what our social media pals are saying about this topic today. When it comes to what makes people snobs, Paul Stanley leads us off with money and how they were brought up as kids. Mark Anthony Simonson adds, Providence, snobby, somebody somewhere got things twisted. What makes one a snob? Money and misinformation. Yeah, Patricia Adelio Estrella doesn't like it. I want a redo. Providence has some of the nicest people. As far as snobby people, it's their loss. They could miss out on meeting some really great people. And lastly, when it comes to what makes a snob, other than an ascot, Donna Mello Stanley says simply, attitude.
That's it. Mm-hmm. That's